by Ron Goodall. He himself is the maintainer of the API up to 2030, San Francisco Hackathon, and he is simply explaining how API works and what API can do. I'm just learning the API slowly, and I'm here to understand the same thing, how we can connect to API. If time permits, then we can have a small application based on jQuery. I think everybody is familiar with jQuery. Yeah? Okay. So it's application programming interface, getting data. Okay. Everybody knows, okay? So you can pull the data from a MediaWiki software into your application. Maybe that is an Android application or a desktop application or some other thing. Or even a server processing mechanism or some kind of bot logic or something. Okay, so by using accessing this API, you can read the data from all the websites based on MediaWiki. That means all Wikipedia websites, Wikia is there. I think every API is built in. There is a lot of ways to block that API, but by default that is enabled. So you can pull from, not from Wikipedia, neither from, you can pull from Wikipedia, but also you can pull from all other, these kind of websites, okay? Okay, this is, these are the people who created the API. Ron Kadao himself is present. That's a great presentation, nearly 1 hour. Okay. So, there is a main use for that. Okay. MediaWiki is basically based on PHP, and MariaDB is the backend. It is running on, you can run it on Nginx or you can run it on Apache, no problem. Output, the output of the API, generally the output of the API, we will get a JSON output, or we can switch to HTML. Lot of other outputs are mentioned there, but most of the, they recommend to use JSON as the default. Okay, you can go to HTML, XML itself, but JSON is the recommended format. JSONP is also supported. I think everybody know JSONP. Okay. So the endpoint request is the API.php. The point. So you are a MediaWiki powered website slash API.php is the default thing. You just go. Wikipedia.org/w/api.php. If you run that, then you will get the latest updated documentation about API. He himself is telling that this documentation is auto-generated. Auto-generated from the code itself. So from the comments and to-dos or everything is written inside the code, they are generating this information from that thing. So this is the most updated one. You must refer to this thing. Just put w/api.php. And it is a RESTful API. I think everybody know what is a RESTful API. Okay? Are you comfortable with that? That is not? Yeah. So again, skipping that. Okay, the details are in API main page. There is a documented detailed documentation. Okay, our mediawiki.org/api.mainpage. And API tutorial is start point. See, this is how you use it, okay, all details are here. And this is the much more elaborated course about the tutorial. So you can go through all those ones. Okay, what we can get? Okay, all public information in a MediaWiki powered website. Means you can pull articles, categories, user pages, history, metadata, links, images, docs, special pages, sandboxes, everything. What is all public data available inside a media view powered site, you can pull using this api.php. Okay. And that is the problem is versioning. Okay, every now and then MediaWiki is releasing its updated version. And API version also changes. Told that they are making their best practice to be compatible with older versions. That API will never break and new features are not available. So if you query another website, okay, Wikipedia's websites or Wikimedia Foundation's websites are running on the latest MediaWiki software. If you are going to going on another website, so you just check the version of the MediaWiki and you refer to the corresponding documentation. That's a basic difference. And generally, all code will work there. Okay. So next is API sandbox. You just go this thing. There is a MediaWiki sandbox in every MediaWiki powered website. There you can run a query. This is the sandbox you have. For English Wikipedia, en.wikipedia.org/wiki/special:api. If you can just pull this page, then you know. Okay, this is a modern interface. Before that, it was not this much sophisticated. It was a little buggy and little hard to operate. But this version is very good. So you can check, can tick, untick, change all the options using this sandbox. Okay, the default is main page and format is equal to JSON. If you make a request, first we want to define an action here. Action, there are a lot of actions are available. You just go through that, then you get fine. Lot of actions are here. These are the actions performed with this API. Generally, query is the read. Query is used to read from media. Okay. So action is query. If you click this thing and click this query point, then there is another small thing will appear before, after that. That is called action is equal to query. So all the variables after this query, you can select from here. There is a pop is here, list is here, meta is here. A lot of options are here. IWURL, continue, raw continue, titles, page IDs, generator, redirect. There is a small documentation. Just go through that thing, then you can get the idea of how you can generate. Okay, then if you plus make a request, it will generate the URL of the API. So this URL we are putting on our application to pull the data from the API. That is, it's like api.php. Then customer reaction is equal to query and format is equal to JSON. So it will output the JSON form. If you can copy the requirement JSON. So en.wikipedia.org/w/w, I think it is there. Okay. Then it will get, the output. So you can put this URL on your application to query. So you can fit the variable, okay, you can change the EN to say FR or ML or HI, the language will change. Like this. So you can program that thing in that way also. And we can edit with API also. It's a RESTful thing, so you can edit, you can delete, and you can create a new. To write into MediaWiki API, we need a write request. Okay, so from an admin. We need a write request. It will generate an API token. It's a temporary API token, I think for 10 seconds or 10 seconds to 10 minutes. Just check the record. And we put this token into the URL request. Then that edit function will carry out. We go for sample one, which is mentioned in the tutorial. Just take the tutorial page. There's an example query. Action is equal to query. In the main screen, we select the action is equal to query. Then this second thing will appear. The query is there. Okay. We go prop. Which is the prop? Which property we want to query? Okay. Generator, we are querying the information or property of a page. In MediaWiki software, we are handling everything as a page. So you have a page ID and properties of the page is there. So if you put the property there, that will go to the page. Okay. So in this example, there is prop is equal to images. Prop is means the property. And okay, and then prop is equal to images. IM units. The default IM unit is 500. The output result in a single query request is limited to 500. And 5000 requests for a bot. If you have a bot permission and you are running from a bot, then you will get a 5000 output. What is for it and how the output will look like.
format is here, and I'll drop this into the coordinates. Category information, contributors, coordinates, external links, extracts, lot of information, things, all these things we put all different properly in the page. Okay, so if you go for coordinates, run a lot of queries. There is the categories and titles. Okay, if you change this thing into category, you will get the whole categories. So the category, total category list. Okay, these are the categories put into the page, into this page, in the page title Chandigarh. So again, another query in the reverse order, that you query a category, that you will get the category members. What are the pages under this category? And okay, there is property called language links. You just play with all the properties, and you will quickly understand how it works. Which point? Like this, you can make And revision is the RV prophecy to the content.
You will get the wiki text of the page.
And then there is an example. Prophecy equal to revisions. By default, if you never tick this option, you will get an ID, timestamp, flag, comment, and so on. This is the default page. Okay, you will get the last revision. Page ID and title Chandigarh, revisions. Parent ID, minor, username, timestamp, comment. You will get the revision of the page. You can add more list here.
₹5
Actually, what is this word? This is all, the content, only the content area, content area. There is now the side limbs, top limbs, bottom limbs, all those HTMLs are avoided. It will be past the what is the wiki that's present inside this page. Again, there are a lot of slashes. You just pass that through a jQuery, then you will get a clear output, a clear HTML output. So you will get the content what is there. Inside the Chandigarh page, all those links. And info of a page. Info. And if you go on this prop to change action info, action pass, prop is equal to info. You will get the information on the page. Page ID, title, content model, language, last revised, the total length of the page, language. A lot of information about the page, you will get the information. These are the major queries. These are the major queries used in for a reading model. Okay, revisions are already ID, timestamp, user content and comment, all those things. You get text, you get the text, last revision, last 500 revised text of an article, you can get that from Wikipedia. So, okay, to get the output of an HTML, there are a lot of various ways are there. You can go parse and then page name. Okay, this is the basic. You go action pass and page is equal to Chandigarh. You will get an HTML output of the page. And you can go and prop is equal to text. Then you will get the this slash and must be is there. And if you get you can go in the query mechanism also. You go query, then format JSON. Output extract the then also you will get the output. And extracts is a little much more cleaner. output.
Just try to build the whatever you want to search here. Gather the data from the
query,
parse it, and drop like the API will fetch the raw data, then we are parsing it and changing it to this data, and then like once the data is displayed, we have text to speech conversion. So whatever data is displayed, we are clicking on this icon, and then it displays.
So this is much more cleaner HTML.
UI we can manage. That is not that clear right now, so we will look on that. Maybe some other option.
Extract this looks like this. So the next thing is sections. Now, if you have an article, then you have a heading there, lot of subheadings are there. Inside that there is lot of other subheadings are there. So you can extract a portion of text under a subheading using this section. If you look into that query, you can understand that action is equal to parse, format is equal to JSON, scope is equal to section. Only the change is in the prop. Just go prop to change to prop. Extract change to sections.
And then we have this JavaScript for converting.
So prop is equal to text.
So Java, we cannot use JavaScript.
Action is equal to parse, okay. Change the action. Change parse. Action is equal to parse. And prop is equal to. And here is the title. Sorry, it is not work on the title, it will work on the page. Prop is equal to sections. Section 0 means the primary introduction. Okay, there if you go through a Wikipedia article, you can understand that there is a primary introduction. Then after that introduction, you will get the content. First heading, second heading, etc. And first the primary introduction is section 0. And first subheading is section 1. And it goes. Okay, if you run on a section request. So these are the sections, these are the subheadings in this Chandigarh page. There is etymology is there, history is there, then modern history, geography, location, climate, ecosystem, demographics, population. Okay. you want to pass a section only, then you change this thing into, here is prop is equal to text. From prop is equal to sections, you change to prop is equal to text, and section is equal to 1 means you will get the content inside the first subject. Change to text and here is section. Section is equal to 1. You will get the text inside the first subheading. Okay, if you go for section is equal to 0, you will get the primary introduction. If you search on Google about something, nowadays there is an information box on the right side. Okay, there is a title and there is a brief description. Then go to Wikipedia. The brief description is the primary introduction. That we can pull the information this way. Then jQuery. Are you interested to run sample application? Using jQuery? Okay, this is the order of the documentation. First you go for the latest information, go for api.php. Then there is documentation from India Wiki API page is there. Then API sandbox, there is lot of examples in API sandbox how this query will work, what are the various variables to put in. And that is I have a sample application to study all the things, which is if you type something. On a main page of Wikipedia, there is a search box. If you type something, then it will give you a list. Actually, there is a small information about what is this. It is there in the API, and they have skipped that. So I just put that information on this. So people get a little idea about what it is. So it will work like this. If you one click on this thing, it will go. If you click go, directly go to Wikipedia. If you put a search, then it will run a search for that. You will get various articles in Wikipedia. And you can read on Wikipedia. And if you go on a report, then you will get a text, only text only. So this thing will work on mobile devices with slow internet connection. If you have a dial-up connection speed, 5 kbps or something, then this will work beautifully. The drawback of this program is it's based on jQuery. jQuery itself it comes on 100 kb, nearly 100 kb. But we can rewrite this application avoiding jQuery itself. So you try writing a sample application using this. If you work on commons, with this API, you will get a fantastic result because a lot of images are there, a lot of categorization is there. This is the way the API works. So just go and experiment with that. Okay. Any questions? Then
any questions?
Yeah, it is working. Unicode conversion is working. Yeah. Only thing is sometimes you will get that. Actually, core of the Unicode, parts of that. Some little work, some extra work sometimes, but in most cases it works, no problem. This thing, this is a test project. Okay, I have plans to extend that. Okay, you can also write this thing. I just got this idea about another million people are coming to the internet, how Wikipedia is, and there was a question on Parsi Wikipedia. So I thought that just write a simple program, how it works on a low speed connection. Because India got a low speed connection in Asia. Our speed of internet is low in India. So people are using mobile to access. So I thought that just try a pilot project, then realize the good story. And that's the idea. Okay, actually, you try to write an application, sample application like this, then you can get a better idea about this. Thank you.